All right, the Great Awakening is a movement that starts by the church as a response to the Enlightenment. The ministers, it starts in the north, northern colonies, ministers start to become concerned that people are turning away from religion and applying the scientific thinking. And so they want to like reawaken people's religious ideas and make them feel, not think quite so much. And I'm not trying to suggest that you can't feel and think when it comes to religion, but this is in the context of the 18th century. So the first sermon you have there is by Jonathan Edwards, and he has this, it's a fire and brimstone, sometimes is how it's characterized, right? It's to make us feel anxious. We're just spiders being dangled over the pit of hell, and it's God that keeps us where we are. And he references specifically, let me find the document really quickly, he references specifically, right, people trying to, like, you know, take care of themselves. You probably are not sensible to this. You find you are kept out of hell, but do not see the hand of God in it. You look at other things as to the good state of your bodily constitution, your care for your own life, any of the means you use for your preservation, he says, right? So you think you're doing things that are keeping you healthy, but it's really God, he tells you. And so this started to make people, like, anxious and fearful. If you look over that, you'll see that feeling. And so it worked. People became reawakened and joined the church again in higher numbers. But then something happens with this awakening. It kind of, I don't know if I want to say backfires, but it doesn't continue the way they intended it to. Because what happens is other ministers throughout the colonies take up this call to reawaken people. One of those is a man by the name of Whitfield. He travels to all 13 colonies. So this is one thing that's unique about the Great Awakening, is it's one of the first shared colonial experiences. Whitfield will visit all 13 colonies. All 13 colonies will experience this awakening. Whitfield, though, would talk to large crowds of people. Apparently he had a great method of speaking. People would faint when they heard him speak sometime, and you've got a account by Franklin where he goes to see him, and Franklin says, like, I know he's going to take my money, but I'm not going to give it to him, you know. And remember, Franklin's our enlightened thinker, and by the end, Franklin says he's given him all his money. Now, in Whitfield's defense, he died a pauper and actually gave that money to the poor, but this demonstrates another feature of the Great Awakening. So first, it's a shared colonial experience. Second, when people would be standing in these fields listening to these ministers giving these sermons, they would be with all types of people, upper class, lower class, men, women, indentured, enslaved, free. And that shared experience also made people think differently about, we're still thinking the same about race and sex, but we think differently maybe about class and kind of challenging that hierarchy. And likewise, a lot of these ministers weren't college trained. They were just speaking from how they felt. And so that got people thinking, wait a minute, if this person can do that and gets all this recognition and prestige, then why couldn't I do it too? And so if you start questioning, like, the hierarchy of the church, it's not that much of a leap to start questioning the monarchy, to question, why do you need a king? And then the third reason that Great Awakening is going to matter is it's going to create different ways of interpreting the Christian faith. And so you'll get, like, the creation of, like, Methodist, other religious groups at this time. And that's going to ultimately lead to a sense of wanting to have practice religious freedom, not telling one group how to practice their faith versus another group, which, again, a huge shift from what we saw, you know, say in the 17th century with the Puritans who executed Mary Dyer for being a Quaker. So again, these three things, it's a shared colonial experience, it gets people challenging hierarchies, either because of the shared experience listening to these ministers or because of who the ministers themselves were. If you can challenge hierarchies, maybe you could also challenge a king. And three, it gets people aware of different ways of approaching faith. And ultimately, we can connect with freedom of religion. All right, if you've got any questions, you can put those in the discussion module. Take care.